Hello, Mr. Nigren here. Welcome to Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich, a superhero parody game. This game is very mod friendly. So, at first they released Freedom Force in 2002, I believe. I randomly bought a copy of that game in the store long ago. I don't remember the year when I bought it. Probably 24 or something. Anyway, this is the expansion, Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich. It's a standalone expansion. I actually bought a copy of this game a year ago, I believe, or maybe just half a year ago, on eBay, I believe. Or it was the Swedish eBay site, Tradera. It's like eBay, but a Swedish site. Okay, and used to be owned by eBay for some time. Okay, so this game has a story mode where you play as some heroes and are about to save the world from some villains. You return to World War II and then you fight to stop the evil guys from taking over the world. And it's a mix between action and strategy. So you have like an overview where you can click on the select the units, and you have four units that you can control. Four heroes. Sometimes you control one, sometimes you control four. And so you can control everything from one to four. And they have different abilities and such, and you take turns moving them. But it's like a real time system, so it won't pass for the enemy to move. You can pause the game and then you do the moves. Okay, so I have already finished this game on my YouTube channel years ago. My old YouTube channel, I had the entire game finished. I even had a character with my own looks that looked very much like a younger version of me. Anyway, I want to play a mod for this game called I believe something about Marvel Universe. It's a huge mod. It received a new update this year. So I deleted my old version from 2019 that I had playtested and played some of the new, but the problem with the new one was that it had some graphical errors. Some of the enemies were pink and I couldn't really use abilities with Wolverine in his story mode. There were some issues that I didn't have with the older version. I believe the new version added more characters and probably some improvements to the mod, but I think the old one from 2019 was more bug-free, so to speak. So I will re-download that version and play that version instead. It has a lot of cool campaigns. It has like almost 1,000 characters. The mod is adding a huge number of Marvel characters from all the Marvel comics. Okay, and the modder this is name something about Grey. Don't remember. I will look it up. But anyway, his mod has different campaigns. So in this mod you can either play multiplayer over internet or direct IP or LAN, TCP IP LAN, and you fight. If you do that, you fight battles where you control 1 to 4 heroes, and then you fight a friend that is also controlling 1 to 4 heroes. Maybe you can have more than two players. I have never played multiplayer in this game. I believe I tried maybe to connect or LAN when I had the game installed on two computers, but I never have played it with anyone. Okay, so I have finished the original campaign of the expansion. I never finished the campaign of the original game. Also, it has the Rumble Room where you can fight in different stages and select different game modes. Usually you would select the So here the AFF Superhero TV modded feature, which allows you to just watch when chosen heroes are fighting villains. So you choose 1 to 4 heroes. For example, we have now it crashed because I have removed the custom characters, I forgot. But you choose 1 to 4 heroes, and then you click next, and then you choose a bunch of enemies to fight. You can also add certain labels, such as ally, enemy, or neutral, so that they won't necessarily be enemies to you as the player. And then you just watch the fighting. You can also play other modes, such as survival mode and other stuff. But the campaign mode is a story mode, where you follow a story and can only choose the characters of the story. Of course, there is the feature that you can, if you have enough money earned in the campaign, you can hire your own custom characters to the campaign. So in my old Let's Play, I had a character that was myself, pretty much an OP character, an overpowered character that I could use in the campaign, in the later campaign, because I had a lot of money back then. In the later stages of the campaign, I believe the final 2 missions or so. But anyway, this game is easily moddable, so you can easily add new characters. So obviously there are characters from Marvel and DC available, and other stuff. I've even seen Star Wars characters for this mod, for this game, I mean. Okay, so that guy, I don't know if he's named Phantom Grey or something else, but Grey in the name. He made a huge Marvel mod. He's also made a Teenage Ninja Turtles mod and a mod based on old school heroes such as the Phantom. But if we focus on the Marvel mod, Marvel Universe mod, it's a mod which has over almost 1,000 characters available for the Rumble Room, and also it has different campaigns. For example, it has an Avengers campaign, it has an X-Men campaign, it has a Spider-Man campaign, a bunch of different campaigns based on different universes of Marvel. And I play tested as the X-Men. I believe there were a campaign which focused on the entire team that I didn't play, and then there were campaigns for individual characters, for example Wolverine and Gambit and such, and I played a few missions as Wolverine and Gambit. They were taken directly from the comics, and they were very impressive. They were also pretty hard, so I would like to play those missions on my YouTube channel. Okay, it didn't crash, good. But I couldn't use Batgirl. Probably remove the character. Ben Kenobi here, it's a modded character, of course. Haven't given him any skills or attacks or anything. Check only the campaign characters. See, Alchemist Freeze is one of the heroes. Alien Surgeon is one of the enemies. Check the heroes. So Black, yeah, he's one of the heroes from the World War II setting. So they go back in time to stop a villain called Blitzkrieg. And his friends, based on Mussolini and the Imperial Japanese. Okay, so I believe one of the, I don't remember the names, it's been ages since I played. We will certainly replay it. So Blitzkrieg is the main villain of the World War II setting, and he is a super villain. He has a bunch of attacks and powers and such. Okay, so we can choose 4 heroes. Take a Legionnaire, that's a villain. Liberty Lad, Lord Dominion, another boss from the previous game. He has a small role in this game too. And then you choose a bunch of allied troops here. No enemy troops. So I believe in the mod you have the ability to add allies and such neutrals, but in the original game, which we are running now, you only have enemies here that you can add. But we're not gonna do this. So, by the way, in the Rumble mode we might have the actual Freedom Force 1 missions, campaign missions. No, I believe we can play missions of the expansion here. Difference if we play here is that we can choose any heroes that we want. No, they seem to be set. So we only have alchemies in the first mission. Maybe there are some that we can actually choose our own heroes. I believe the first few missions are set, so you can't use anything but the ones they want you to use. Here we can finally add our own stuff. For example, Ben Kenobi can be added. So, and this is a campaign mission. So if we play the campaign in Rumble Room, we can choose our own stuff. If we play it in the new campaign option, we can set difficulty. We have everything from very easy for the complete novice, easy, challenging for new players, normal for the experienced players. Hard, a challenge from veterans, very hard, think you're that good, huh? Possible we want you. So I usually play normal, but not more difficult than that. If you start it, the campaign will start and it will still have the heroes set in place, but I think you can hire your own heroes in certain missions if you have enough money. Well, in the Rumble Room, it's easier to add them, I believe. Doesn't require the same money, or it's just that you have more money in the Rumble Room than you have in let's see, the Rumble Room campaign mission. I'm not sure. I believe you can add anything here. You don't really need. I believe this is the total points of your heroes, and this is the individual points that this character cost. But you have unlimited money, I believe, in Rumble Room. Well, in the single player campaign, you have a limited amount, so that's why it's better to play in the Rumble Room, probably, if you want custom characters. Okay, so Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich. Heroes, Alchemist, Blackjack, Blackbird, Bullet, El Diablo, Eve, Green Jenny, Iron Ox, Law, Liberty Lad, Man of War, Manbot, Mentor, Microwave, Minuteman, he's the main character by the way. Order, Quetzalcoatl, Sea Urchin, Sky King, one of the coolest heroes in the game, Super Collider, Ant, Bard, Tombstone, he's also pretty cool, and Tricolor. Okay. So the villains. Alien Sergeant, Alien Warrior, Blitzkrieg, Blue Darkman, Turian, Chaos Cap, Crooked Cap, Cuban Civilian, Dark Shaman, Deja Vu, Devastation Wrath, and Trophy, she's like the final boss of the campaign, Fire Elemental, Flamec, Fortissimo, like the Mussolini villain, we have Frost Warrior, Gangster, Glacial Giant, Green Sylph, between Ice Trooper, Clarilla Gun, Clarilla Whip, Legionnaire, Lord Dominion, Mayor Eye of the Reich, Manor Tower, McMahon, Manor Eye of the Reich, Mr. Mechanical, Nazi General, Nazi Grenadier, Nazi Gunner, Nazi Rifleman, Nuclear Winter, Pan, Pinstripe, Police, probably a Corrupted Police, Praetor, we have the Purple Dark Man, we have the Raptor, Red October, Red Sun, the Japanese villain, Red Sylph, Smith, the Shadow, the Feral, Silver Sylph, Snowman, Soldier Ant, Subterrestrial, Zuko, T-Rex, Tug with Bat, Tug with Bombs, Tug with Guns, Tantvin Electrical, Tantvin Energy, and Tantvin Radiation. We have Time Master, we have Tough Bat Tug, Tough Gun Tug, Tough Raptor, Wild Raptor, Warwork Rant, and Rate of Chaos. And custom characters. We have a bunch of different heroes. Might remove the Fooler, so I will probably not have most of them. The game might also crash if I click on certain ones. So we need to start a different version of this game if you want to check most of them. I believe I added the Star Wars characters because I wanted to take pictures of them, as we are using the same models for Star Wars Total War, for Rome Total War Alexander. So there you go, Vex is rigging Star Wars models for Rome Total War, or he was doing it. We have released a few demos with Star Wars models, and they were rigged from this game mostly. So we have characters like Aqualish and Aura Singh, Ben Kenobi, Boba Fett, really good model of Boba Fett, yet to be rigged. Bosk, Cassian Andor, yeah, we saw him, Grand Admiral Thrawn, and Solo. So there were two units, two models of Han Solo. This is from episode 5 with the best face, and then there is the Han Solo from episode 6 with the better body. Hey, do not think his face is as good here. No. Okay, we have Jabba the Hutt. We have Jyn Erso. I believe this is the best Jyn Erso model. He looks a lot like the one from the movie. Rogue One. We have Lando Calrissian too. Leia on the speeder. The one we wanted to add to Rome Total War. We have Lubot, Lando Calrissian's like right hand man. There's some Krennic, the evil guy from Rogue One. We have R2-D2, too small to be seen here. Reckon Roid, the Empire. Tarkin, Grand Moff Tarkin. And we have Yoda. From episode 4, I believe. that's all the ones that are available here. Okay, so if we make a new character, we could then add stats to them all the way to Mighty from Phoebo and from Slacker to Quicksilver, from Klutz to Infallible, from Pant Waste to Unstoppable, and from No Energy to Energized. Of course it costs points, character points. So we have Strength, we have Speed, we have Agility, we have Endurance, and we have Energy. And you saw what we could do there. And then we have attributes, we can have up to 5 attributes, I believe. If we buy attributes, we have options here. We have the info of each attribute thrown here. We have adaptive, we have armored, we have beautiful. For example, enemies attempting melee attacks on character must make a successful resistance check against hypnosis because she is beautiful. And then there are a lot of other options. Take one. Stat, we can add up to 5 stats, but we might not want to do that because... I was wrong. Of course, you want up to 5 stats. Let's just take something. So of course, you will find most attributes that fit a certain character. For example, if you have Superman, you will easily find the stuff that suits him. And if you have Spider-Man, you will find stuff that suits him. They are not characters from the main game. So obviously their attacks would not exist within the game, such as throwing spider nets or using Superman's laser vision, for example. So if you want such attacks, you probably need to download the SFX mod, which adds a bunch of new projectiles and such animations to the game. Because I believe batarangs and spider nets and such, they are modded in abilities. They are not within the original game. Also, we have powers. We can have up to 5 powers too. We have the option to add melee attacks. We can add projectiles. We can add beams. We can have a cone, a standard cone attack. Area, standard area power will affect the entire area. Direct power, active defense, passive defense, and a special. And of course, with the SFX mod used by most mods nowadays, you will have more abilities and attacks and attributes for custom characters. In this original game, Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich, you only have the attacks and abilities available from the official game. They won't fit characters like Batman and Superman. But if you add the SFX mod, then probably you will get attacks and abilities that will fit such characters too. And also, if you want those characters, you need to get them from the internet, the same way I got the Star Wars characters. But problem with Star Wars is that they need unique attacks for the Star Wars characters, like for example laser beams, and I am not sure if there are attacks that fit them. Maybe some of the enemies had laser attacks, but otherwise they might run into trouble due to the game not having the suitable attacks. Okay, so for example a Sith Lord like Palpatine would have problems, because he wouldn't be able to use his electric shots. I don't believe there are anyone shooting electricity. Excuse me. Okay, so this is Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich. and I will most likely play through the original game. I also kind of want to play the original game, Freedom Force, before playing Freedom Force with the Third Reich. So I have finished the Third Reich expansion pack on my old YouTube channel that was removed in like 2010. But I had none of the episodes backed up, unfortunately. And back then I played without speaking, so it was a walkthrough where I just played. Played a bunch of episodes. Episodes were limited to 10 minutes 59 seconds, I believe. So each episode was about 11 minutes long. And I had finished this game. But I never played the original. So we will believe there should be mods for this expansion pack adding the levels of the originals. I will try to find those mods. Then we will obviously play the first game first, which has a longer campaign than the expansion. And then we'll play the expansion pack. And when we're done with the expansion pack, and by the way, this game is not that long. It has a bunch of missions, but it shouldn't take too long to finish. But anyway, when we're done with the main games, we will play the Marvel mod, I believe. Maybe we'll even start playing the mod before we are done with the main game, because we could play them simultaneously. And by the way, I did a mistake. I had a Torchlight Let's Play going on since 2020, but unfortunately I found out that I could add a bunch of mods for it. I didn't know there were mods for it, so I played the original game, two long episodes, where I finished the two first acts of Torchlight. Then, unfortunately, when I realized I could add a bunch of mods, I added so many mods that I broke the save. So the save game didn't work anymore, I couldn't load it. And then I had to restart everything, which I did. I modded everything first, and when I restarted it, I had a blonde character instead of a black haired character, but I still played the Alchemist. By the way, I had done a lot of personal modifications for it. I had added a bunch of new character classes, and I had done a lot of stuff, but all of that, I believe, I replayed everything I had done. So I had played for 7 hours, 7.5 hours without recording. So in total I played the game for about 14 hours, because I had played those 14 hours prior to the modding, where I had uploaded videos. So I played the first two acts. It took about 7 hours 30 minutes. Then I modded the game and everything got corrupted, so I had to restart everything. So I modded the game again and made sure that it worked, and then I replayed everything up to the point where I would be able to continue the Let's Play. And this time I had a blonde version of the Alchemist female character, and I also had the ability to play as a bunch of cool classes, because I had added all the character classes that are available through mods. Some of them were very interesting. I also had downloaded a specific model of a character and managed to modify it myself. So I had added a sorceress, because there were like the Diablo 2 sorceress had been added in terms of skills and attacks to one of the characters. Then I managed to replace the model with a model of Torchlight that looks a lot like the sorceress. But unfortunately, I did a mistake, and the story is such that I had two versions of the CD for Torchlight. I gave one to my sister, and the other one I used myself, because there were no multiplayer. I bought two copies of the CD because I thought we could play LAN in this over TCP IP, but unfortunately Torchlight 1 didn't have multiplayer. So that's why I gave her the other copy, but I had a CD version myself that I kept, and that's the one I used when I played the game in 2020. But then I found a mod on an internet site which added multiplayer in Torchlight 1, but in order to use it you needed needed Steam and the version of Torchlight on Steam, so I bought that version specifically to be able to try out the multiplayer, and it worked, but certain quick buttons didn't work well, so it was a little bit annoying to play with the multiplayer, but otherwise it worked like a TCP/IP LAN kind of multiplayer. The problem is that both players need a copy of the game and a copy of Steam. So for example, if I would want to play with my sister, for example, she likes this type of game. The Torchlight is like Diablo 2, an action RPG. So if I would want to play with her in Torchlight using that mod, she would need to start up and create a Steam user, Steam account, and then she would need to buy the game and install the mod on her version as well, and then we could play. So the problem is that we need Steam on both computers. Everyone that wants to play it in multiplayer needs Steam. So it wasn't possible to use it on the CD version of the game. That's why I bought the Steam version. And the problem is that my SSD drive that I bought in the summer of 2020 stopped working and started to crash and disappear and such randomly when I did stuff on it. Everything is shut down, and all of a sudden I couldn't find the disk. It was like it didn't exist, so it couldn't be found by the computer. That's a sign that the drive is about to shut down. I also spoke to a guy that told me that his SSD drive had shut down a year after he had bought it. So they seem to only last for a year or so, which is very short. Which is a very short amount of time, in my opinion. But anyway, this means that I moved the Medieval 2 and all the mods to a different drive. Uninstall everything on my SSD drive, everything on Steam. So I uninstalled Total War Warhammer 2, Rome 2 Total War, Shogun Total War, Tila Total War, and a bunch of other games that I had on Steam. And unfortunately, I were using Steam with Torchlight 2 and I forgot to back up my save. So I lost all the progress I had done. So now if I want to continue Torchlight, I would need to restart everything again and replay those 7.5 hours, which I don't want to do right now. So that's the problem. I need to replay everything, and before I can play it, I will need to add all the mods and such, and find. I will need to go through a huge list of mods and pick all the mods that I want. Then I will need to make sure that they are loaded in the correct order and that they work and that the game is not unstable. And after that, it should work fine. But I had some problems getting that mod that had added characters to work, so it will be another uphill battle to get that to work again. I remember it being tedious. And also that sorcerer's model, I believe it required me to do some editing. I could probably do it again, but it's annoying. Did a mistake with Torchlight. I should have moved the Torchlight folder out of my Steam library, like I did with Medieval 2. So I didn't back up the Rome to War game either. I thought I could reinstall it. I had most of the mods in other locations, but I lost some of the stuff, like the, I believe, my avatar campaign. I had only uploaded one episode, but I believe it got deleted when I deleted the Steam library. But I'm more upset with the Torchlight game, because that's 7.5 hours that I lost. They had also replayed it once, so it's 14 hours pretty much that I have played, that I will now have to discount. I will need to replay everything, so it's like I haven't played those 14 hours already. I can't start where I were. I need to restart everything. Okay, so in Freedom Force vs. the Third Reich, it's possible to record with the NVIDIA Shadowplay recorder. The last time I tried it, I believe the game shut down. So I'm surprised it works. Yeah, but this is the original game. It might have been a mod where I failed to use it. We'll try it with the mods. It might not work, but we'll see. Okay, bye.